Atrial fibrillation is the most common arrhythmia in humans. It's also called AF, AFib, but it's all the same, namely an irregular rhythm where the atrium is effectively quivering very, very, very rapidly, and as such, the ventricle, which is the bottom chamber of the heart, cannot keep up, and so it pitter-patters irregularly without any rhyme or reason, and that's the classic findings of atrial fibrillation, namely an irregular pulse. The symptoms that patients often report with atrial fibrillation are variable, but includes palpitations, shortness of breath, fatigue, lightheadedness, rarely chest pain, but just a generalized feeling of being unwell. Yeah, the question I get a lot is, is AFib normal for my age? And the simple fact is AFib can occur in any age. It's roughly proportionate to the decade of life you're in. And so roughly 2-3% of all 20 to 30 year olds have atrial fibrillation. It's up to 10% of all patients over the age of 80. That sweet spot tends to be the 5th, 6th, 7th decade of life, where it's roughly 5-8%. It is not just for patients at a certain age demographic. We have a lot of patients really across the age spectrum. If you look back over someone's life, they almost always will tell you, I started off with self-limited palpitations. They became more frequent, longer lasting. Eventually they go into the arrhythmia and they potentially don't come out until some strategy is undertaken. Untreated atrial fibrillation is problematic for a couple different reasons. One is that, especially if you're not on the requisite blood thinning strategy, we know that the stroke risk over time is cumulative, and as such, at least blood thinning strategies are essential with atrial fibrillation if one's risk is high enough. The secondary issue with atrial fibrillation is over time, intermittent AFib, paroxysmal is the term we use, AFib that you go in and out of on your own, eventually progresses into AFib that you go into and perhaps don't come out of on your own. Now that process in some patients can take weeks to months. More commonly, it's years to even decades. And then eventually you will go into atrial fibrillation and not come out ever effectively if nothing's done.